Alright, I just managed my social media presence here, so we're gonna start a little bit early. How dare you not have heard of this game? Yeah, lots of people haven't heard of it. It's one of the best... It's probably my favorite Metroidvania, like, ever. I really, really love this game. 1999X. I don't think that extra 9 used to be there in the original translation. I originally played this game using an unofficial translation, and some parts of the unofficial translation I actually liked better. I'm not sure if they were accurate, but basically the story is completely ridiculous and doesn't make any sense. Though there's actually some little bits that actually come back, but basically the story here is Bunny is a bunny, and bunnies control time, just like in real life, and because of a nuclear catacular explosion, she grows cat ears. And then this fat bunny guy says, hey, I'm gonna help you remove your curse by, you know, going through this dungeon here. However, a bullet comes out and slaughters him. So. Off we go. And one of the funniest thing is, those are your controls, I already know them. So, one of the funny things is, you can't move right when you start the game. You can move right by holding right and jumping, or by doing a backdash, but you can't turn around and just walk to the right. Yes, Bunny is definitely adorable. And so you get this item, which allows you to walk to the right! Which is, you can beat the game without that item that lets you walk to the right. Oh, right, there's a heart up here. An unfortunate thing, this game is very hard. Well, it's very technical. It's not super crazy hard if you know what you're doing. Lots of people don't know what they're doing, and so this first part, you know, like, I've heard of people that can't beat the first boss. What is the game where you evolve the RPG? I have no idea what you're talking about. That is not this game. This is Bunny Must Die. And we get time power here. Since Bunny is a bunny, you control time just like other normal rabbits. We can do that with circle, but we don't want to waste our time power right now. Also, you destroy lanterns just like Castlevania. There's lots of Metroid and Castlevania's references in this game. Come here. Light sword? You have a defective bunny. Most bunnies control time. It happens, okay? My biggest advice for fighting this boss is save here at this save point and get the light sword. I love the old version of that. The old version of that quote, she says, "Shut up, you fat cow!" And it's just hilarious. Because Bunny's just psychotic over no reason. A lot of things people don't know about this boss. Well, number one, you can bounce on her head. If you jump straight up, you can do the stomp. And you can do some good damage to her that way. Like, lots of people can't beat that first boss, and it's kind of sad. She's really not that hard, but you gotta know what you're doing. But you just save at that save point over there. And you hit her with this, with the sword, and now we can run. That's another frustrating thing with the base controls. You can't run by default. You have to collect those. It's super early on, but lots of people don't have quite the impression of the depth of controls you get in this. It's not a typical weeaboo girl. She's a psycho, and I love her. So, here's our first area, like, gate. Like, to get over here, you need dash. Though you can, by bouncing off the laser of this guy, do a sequence break. And one of the cool things about this game, it totally knows about sequence breaks. And if you beat the second boss before the first boss goes into pissed off boss mode and actively says, "Hey, what the hell? I'm supposed to be the first boss." And she gets insanely difficult, and it's great. I'm not doing that first, because that would end poorly. Now, for this boss, the Black Uwingu is the ideal weapon. However, we can just beat him with kicks. If I'm lucky. Aw, damn it, that was a very bad kick. What you want to do is kick, and your kicks do insane damage. And you do not touch him, because touching him is, like, crazy damage. Yes! That was actually pretty tactical. It was very hard to, not die in that fight, if you don't know what you're doing. There's a reason I practiced these first two bosses before I started streaming. But you have, what, like, four or five different weapons. They all act pretty differently. The Blackwing has limited range, but you can throw out a lot of them. I actually don't really prefer it to the normal weapon. There really isn't any particular cheap move in this game. It's not forgiving in any sort of way like that. I guess the cheapest move there is the wall jump. There's a thing that's supposed to make you bounce off walls at like an angle, but if you use it right, you can actually climb walls straight up, and you can avoid certain... you can completely skip certain puzzles in that. I don't really see myself playing Plasma Burst again. It was a neat little game, but it's not really my kind of thing. Also, to get here, we have to get the second time power. I don't actually use time powers as often as I should, but we're gonna get one that is very important. Excuse me. These pumpkin dudes are in every game. This game is made by Platinatus Botif, one of my favorite Japanese indie developers. And he has these pumpkin guys in all of his games, and I'm not entirely sure why. Like, they're just his trademark, kind of. Oh, right. This is how I get it. You got a key. What up? I love Bunny's English when she, like, picks up power-ups. You'll probably hear me mimic her English a lot. You'll just have to get used to that. I love it. How could you not be into Metroidvanias? This game is great. I highly recommend it to everyone. It's on Dashura and Gamersgate, I think. It's trying to get on Steam through Steam Greenlight, but Steam Greenlight is a raging piece of shit, so that's probably not gonna happen anytime soon. You know, there's not enough zombies for this to get on Steam Greenlight. Yeah, how we deal with this? This puzzle is impossible to solve normally because this timer is too quick. So what you do is you reverse time. And that's something we'll see in a bunch of, things here. You're not allowed to have opinions. No opinions allowed. Oop. Oh crap, did I even save? Spikes hurt. Spikes are not instant death. But, oh crap, did I get the... Oh well. I know where I need to go. If you don't like Metroidvanias because of length, this game is actually very short. You can beat it within an hour if you're really good. I can beat it within about 2 hours, which is my goal, this stream. Time up, power up! I was trying to show you a shitty weapon and I hit the spikes. One fun fact, you can avoid damage by pressing a directional button right as you get hit. It's a pretty tricky technique to get down, and I have not practiced it, so I'm probably not great. I'll show it to you once I get the dynamite body item. Metroidvania games are games in the style of Super Metroid or, I forgot to record chat. There we go. Metroidvania games are games in the style of Super Metroid or Castlevania Symphony of the Night. This game also has really cool music, though I prefer the music in the original version here. This game actually has two versions of music. The original PC release had one set of music, and the English release now has two sets, like a rearranged set. Some of the movements are very technical, like you gotta be able to jump immediately as you jump. Lots of people complain about the controls. They're really very precise. It's sort of like... It's a lot like Mega Man in that at first the controls might seem bad, but really they're just very precise, and once you know what you're doing... I need the self shooter. Once you know what you're doing, it feels really, really good. Oh. That is how you block a thing. You press a button right as you're about to take damage. Like, within a few frames. It's pretty precise. I did manage to pull it off there. Trick for this, you just gotta walk forward and jump. Now our jump damage is tripled. And we can also bounce off of torches, which becomes relevant in certain stages. How could you not like the the Zero series? That's one of my favorites. Oh right, you're the not Metroidvania guy. I really thought the Zero series was very well done. Definitely more so than the later X games, like anything past X5. Better be sorry. Alright, now let's place that. One thing I often do in this game is accidentally forget to bring this red key with me, so that's important. Alright. These bunny dolls will actually let us replay an area. It's sort of like an extra life, but they're limited in number, and like you have to replay the whole area again, so like you can't just immediately respawn. You also have to use a... Oh. Alright, cats. Ah, shit. I needed to kill that first. We're gonna try for this bunny doll. Alright. One annoying thing about restarting this game is sometimes I forget which power-ups I have. Alright. Run! Run, bunny, run! Oh, crap. We're not gonna make it. But we can reverse time and just barely get it. Another secret over here? Excuse me. Whoa, that was bad. Let's get that. Power up! This game is definitely not rage quit level. The only people quit, like, if you just understand some basic controls very early on, I think you won't have too much trouble with this game. Like, you might want to follow a guide. Like, I don't know, I really didn't have too much trouble. I did follow a guide. Some of the secret stuff is pretty hard to find, but you shouldn't have too much trouble finishing. Oh, right, there's one screw you moment. There is one thing you'll definitely want a guide for. I'll point that out later. But it's decently late in the game. I would definitely recommend giving this game a shot. Just ask me if you're having trouble, really. I would love to help anyone playing this game. What I want... Yeah, I'll use that. Alright, mini boss time! This guy's not too hard, you just gotta keep hitting him, and after a certain point... Aw, crap. He will start shooting crazy fast. And then you're in kind of trouble. The good news is as long as you kill him before he starts spamming like crazy, he's not that big of a threat. And you can just save back here anytime. And bosses never respawn. So you can just beat many bosses then save. It's Kitty! In the original game, this was just a picture of an actual cat. And so were all of its non-flame graphics. It was hilarious. Aw, crap. And this game is technical, but not quite on a... Oops. Not quite on a fighting game level where you're gonna need to know, like, lots of combinations and, like, super tight timings. You're gonna need to be able to jump, like, immediately. Uh-oh. And you're going to be able to need to know what to do. The cat's tells are his animations in the background there. More curses, thanks. In the original, she just yells, "I'm already cursed!" And it's hilarious. Well, not in the original. In the unofficial fan translation of the Japanese game. This game was originally Japanese only and took forever to come out in English. Excuse me. This is one of the more annoying jumps in the game, surprisingly. Oh, this is something lots of people have trouble with. If you are not moving forward, you can jump straight up, and you have a higher jump height. If you're walking and you jump, you do a spin, and you have lower jump height, but further horizontal distance. So for this jump, what you want to do is jump straight up. You need the height here, so you jump straight up and then move over. lots of people don't realize that. It went off for a bit. I don't show any dropped frames. Oh right, I need the sword here. Ah, crap. Oh well, we'll save. Also an interesting mechanic, it must be Twitch, because I have literally zero drop frames. Oh, another trick, you can bounce off of enemies. So if you're having trouble with this jump, all you really need to do, you should probably kill that guy below first, is bounce off this guy. Or his fire and completely ruin your own jump. Let's try that again. Okay, actually jumping off this guy is probably harder than the normal jump. But I want to show it off anyway. Fuck that. Never mind. An interesting feature of this game is, it's very well designed for speedruns and stuff. When you save, it actually adds to your timer. So if you want to go for the lowest time, you gotta save as rarely as possible. What do you mean, what is Kitty saying? You beat Kitty quite a while ago. Oh, right, I don't need to be. Wait. Is there secrets? There are secrets in some rooms that I forget. I know there's one down there that I can't get quite yet. And she's a bunny, not a kitty. If you notice at the top, all of Bunny's English is translated, briefly. That is actually something that was also added in the English release. It was not in the original Japanese release, of course it wasn't the Japanese release. But yeah, there's subtitles when she says stuff now. Yeah, just in case. I forget what I was gonna say. Oh, right, this. There are lots of, super minor puzzles when you're trying to get stuff that, hurts you, and there are a lot of rooms that I completely breezed through now that took me, five times to get through the first time. Your first time through will be much, much harder than I'm currently doing here. There's lots of technical stuff you need to understand. Do I want this? Sure. The block is very important to know, but the game only tells you when you're at the very starting screen. And you don't quite know it's important then. If you get frustrated with this game, definitely check out a guide before you quit. Right, we can't do anything here. And in a moment here, we will actually see the second character run by in a cutscene. Actually, I think we see her just for a few frames, maybe. But it's sort of interesting, the stories of the two characters intertwine just a bit. That was Chelsea. She broke gates. We can't break gates. That's one of her features. And yeah, this gate is permanently broken since Chelsea broke through it. One very important thing to remember, grab this stupid orb, because you can get pretty far up here. We're going up next. And you can get decently far up there without the red orb, and then you have to come all the way back. Oh wait, no. I forget exactly when you need it, but just remember to take it when you leave that area. Sometimes it pays to be patient. Unless you can block everything like a boss, which I can't. Also, you can use time to stomp on things, but in this area there are pumpkin ghosts that'll attack you. I think this is the only area that does that, but just because you can stop time doesn't always mean you're completely invincible. Oops. There are actually secrets over here. Light sword? According to the subtitle, she says light sword, but I really think she says my sword, or light sword. At least, it's more amusing if I think it, she says light sword. Power up! Oops. Oh god. Okay. Calm down. With spikes around, it's very easy to panic and take a shit ton of damage. So, don't do that. There we go. Bunny isn't underage. You'll see. You'll all see. This is not the ideal weapon to take right now, but I'm gonna take the Spike Uhama. Oops. Spike Uhama! Spike Hammer is very fun. It, like, swings around. And if you get it just right, you can have it swing around you infinitely. It also does, like, crazy damage. Not quite 50. There is a time power that, well, you'll see it. You'll know it when you see it. It is my favorite time power. Ouch, it adds 60 seconds to your time. That's brutal. This is another one of the, like, largely invisible secrets. There's nothing necessary hidden behind invisible secrets. Ah, crap. You do need to bounce off of these guys, so you want to be careful here. To bounce off of enemies, you just hold the jump buttons. That one usually takes me a few tries, but you can just pop right back in and fight for that one. I never forgive. Alright, there's another bunny doll up here. Die. Alright. It's generally a good idea to get rid of these guys just because they're kind of annoying. Bunny doll right in this corner here. Excuse me. Also, a nice thing about the Spike Hammer, it beats certain shielded enemies in one hit, like this guy. His shield normally won't take any damage, but it's an instant kill with the Spike Hammer. Also, if these guys press you into a wall with a shield, it's an insta-kill, which is annoying. Another secret right here. Also, sometimes everything you see is a lie. Anytime you see a bunny doll or something, there's always a way to get it. Also, if you're having trouble with these platforms, you can stop time. An item over here. One very mean thing about this. This item lets you jump off of walls. And if you practice in this room, you jump into the spikes. And it really, really hurts. I have done that twice. You don't do it. We can now get up the tall shaft over to the left there that has one of the better items in the game, but I do not have the key necessary to get that good item, so we're not even going to take a look. Okay, we're going to try for one of the trickier bunny dolls. Well, not really tricky, just more annoying. Excuse me. Also, so this is the jumpy thingy. It lets you do that, and one thing the game doesn't tell you about, if you hold right, or if you mash right, you can climb walls with it, which is not necessary to beat the game, but lets you do lots of cool stuff. No, there's no screw attack. There's no game-breaking upgrade that, you know, lets you kill everything. The game is, even with all of the tricks and stuff, oops. The game's intended to be very technical and not, you know, super easy to break or anything. It's easy to break in that you can do lots of sequence breaks, but they are very hard. And they make the game much, much harder. Another secret over... maybe it's higher up? There is a way in here. Come on, bunny. There we go. Oh, right, you need to press a switch to get in there. I think there's a time or health up there. Most of the upgrades in the game, most of the harder to get secrets are just, you know, health or time up. to get the good ending, you do need a certain amount of time ups, so that's the only quote-unquote required power-up aside from the items. Oh, shit. Another thing you do not want to forget, never forget the keys. There are certain areas where you need keys. Oh cool, an I Am Error room. Yeah, I've still never seen I Am Error. I know it's crazy rare. You know anything? The spikes deal like 2 health power-ups worth of damage, which is a lot. Even later game, it's pretty decent, and right now it's near fatal. Oh right, that gets broken. Oh. I lied, by the way. You don't need to get that red thing before you go up here. You just need to get it before you go back to the right. Oh, there's a map, by the way. I don't use the map very much because I remember the majority of the game by heart. But the map is very useful. The map also marks off where your items are. So what I like to do is have a map. I always have one save file where I found all of the items so I can tell which rooms have all the items. Like, if I know where to look, I can find everything in the game. But there's some stuff I just won't notice when I'm just, you know, burning through a normal playthrough. Come on, Bunny. Oh, and one thing about Bunny that lots of people don't like, but I kind of like, it makes sense. She has edge gravity, so she won't walk over an edge unless you really try. Like, if you just do a tap, she won't fall over. Well, she's proving me wrong. But she's got a little bit of edge gravity there, which kind of makes sense if you think about it, because in reality, it's actually pretty hard to accidentally fall off an edge. Alrighty. Also, you can take screenshots in the game, and if Bunny is standing completely still, she does a little pose, which is cute. Bunny's not a mutant rabbit. She's a completely normal rabbit that controls time and looks mostly like a human. And the ears are totally not a headband. This is one of my least favorite rooms in the game. Let me show you. Okay, first thing you want to do in this room, kill those pumpkin guys. They suck. Now what you do is press this key, or press the switch, and then the gate opens. Easy enough, right? You just need to run over here. The timing is pretty precise though. So what you want to do is run and do a run kick, get up here, dash, and there you go. Wow, that was perfect. Trust me, it's a lot harder than it looks. But, this is not harder than it looks. Let me show you the second way to get through this. Run, and you all climb right the fuck over it. I hate this room and I never do it voluntarily, though I happen to do it perfectly, which serves me right. And these things, you can stomp on for infinite time. They're usually in rooms where time power is necessary. Also, you need to be good at timing to, get some of the extras in this game. You need to be able to, you know, change time really quickly. I recommend playing this game with a controller, by the way. Do not, unless you have to, don't play this with a keyboard. It is not designed for keyboardness. Keyboard is not the master race when it comes to platformers. Ever. Don't even fool yourself. Also, secret switch. Oops. Whatever. There are lots of puzzles that you can skip with either a time stop, like these stupid things, or time reverse. I'm not sure I would consider Cave Story floaty, but I consider floaty a pejorative. Kick Pro. This is an area laden with secret- well, not really laden, but there's some optional stuff in here. If you screw up, you just want to stay here and go back. Secret. Oh yeah, Bunny definitely lands flip. Bunny is not an aerial character. Also, fun fact, if you stop time, Oh, right, you can't stop time because there's a time cat here. Time cats are douchebags. We'll see the time cat in a minute. Do I have the item for the... You need the spike hammer to kill the time cat. Not sure where you'd get that. Also, you can circumvent the normal way of doing that by using the jump. Also, this wall... completely fake. We need to press that button for reasons I can't quite remember. We need this spike hammer. That's not the spike hammer. There's a spike hammer somewhere. That was close. Here we go. Spike hammer. This time cat, if you exit the map while this time cat is active, you get rebooted to the start of this area. So, we kill him. You need the spike hammer to kill him. Oh god, this boss. I do not like the boss coming up. Well, I don't like the mini boss. The boss himself is dangerous too. But this chick, she's a lot like Death. Well, she's got... crap. She's got the flying sabers a lot like Death from Castlevania. She's not too bad if you keep calm and avoid... oh god, oh god, oh god. Badness. This might be bad. This is very bad. Damn it! Alright, from now on, we're gonna use a time doll instead of reloading saves. I just feel it's the proper way to play the game. You have a limited number of time dolls. Those are the bunny dolls at the bottom right of your menu. And so after I get the bunny dolls, I try to never load a save. Like, I try to play it in one either solid playthrough or never reloading to not, you know, take a break. You know, I never want to reload because I died. I just use the bunny dolls. Yeah, I really don't like her. She's only got a couple attacks, and her pattern's not too complicated. Aw, god damn it! I can't believe I did that. I just often end up hitting the spikes. Also, you can't... there's some tactical stuff in this game that's a bit too complicated to explain right now. Damn it. I really don't like her. You need to jump straight up to bounce off of those lasers, by the way. And to bounce off of these. So you can't... you have to just stand still and jump. Instead of, I think I need to stop talking while I come here. There we go! Your reward is this. Save point. She's wearing a decent amount of clothes. She's wearing, like, ow. I always fall for that stupid thing. She's wearing a decent amount of clothes, come on. This guy used to speak in German, and now he speaks in memes. I kind of preferred when he spoke in German. What happened? What? It's you. All your base are belonging to us. Yeah. This guy is Dracula. Also, he flashes you and instant kills you. If you're looking in his direction when he does the flash attack, seriously, instant kill. That is the hint of the instant kill, by the way, when he just stands stills and there's a fire. And he ends every pattern with the flash. So do not look in his direction when he does that. My favorite way of killing him is with the stomps. Just because how can you not love stomping your stiletto heels into someone's skull? How can you not? That is the point of stiletto heels. Don't let any fashion experts tell you otherwise. Also, you can run through his cloak. It's very dangerous, though. This guy, if you touch this guy, instant kill. Alright. Also, you can go up here. Actually, let me just show you the screw you. This is the one part I consider kind of unfair. Damn it. Not this. Wait, I don't need to... what am I doing? The interesting thing here is, you need to actually let that gate fall, and then you need to reverse time twice. The puzzles of this game are... like, once you figure them out, they're pretty minor, but they're still pretty neat. Also, fun fact, if you stand on this area too long, a UFO comes and it abducts you, and it counts as a death, but it gives you an achievement. There it is! We're not gonna get abducted. money can be spared the probing for now. This part is mean. So, all right, we got a red gate. I can't put it down here. If you get a green orb, you can put the green orb down, and then the game says, what? Is that a bug? What's actually going on here is... oh. The game sometimes hides stuff. You've probably noticed that by now, but I mean, I never would have guessed, like, I don't know. I never got stuck on this, but it seems kind of mean. But, ow. That was bad. I usually do this part first. It's not a dick, it's challenging. I can never feel very mad at this game. Alright, this is a trickier one. You have to have the hyper heals to do this. What you do is you run in, hold jump, and you run in. Ah, crap. That was bad. Alright, you run off. Alright. Let me think of how to describe this. Okay, you run in, and you get off the edge, and you hold jump, and then you bounce off of the two torches. The difference is challenge is awesome, and being a dick is not. Alright, I think this unlocks something important later on. Dark King's Lair. In the original game, when you broke torches here, the brightness would decrease, like the actual overall brightness. In this game, it like has a visible area, like the circle here shrinks. In the original game, the game just got darker, and you could circumvent it by increasing the brightness on your monitor, which I think is part of why they just went for this method. Also, I love this. This is a great joke. Remember what this says. It's too dark to read what is written here. It's not good when you know what's like, I don't know. I just thought it was really good. There's a fourth color of key. Stop this. All right, this one, what weapon do I have? Light sword, that's not really ideal. In this area, you want to kill as many of these guys as possible without destroying too many lights, or torches rather. Come on, get over here. This is being overcautious, really. Need to kill this guy. Okay, there goes all of my torches, basically. You need to kill all these guys before your run, because you're gonna need time on your side. And this one's like impossible. Okay, we're gonna wait for that to go away because I hate that weapon. That's a homing missile and it does really weak damage and it's really... doesn't home very well, it just... I don't like it at all. That was a pretty shitty run, but whatever, we have time. This one is very hard to do without reverse time. Also, secondary secret. I think we've established that Top Hat Wolf does not like anything. Okay, this one. What you need to do is stop time, then jump on here. Then you run and kick up and stop time. Like, you'll fail your first couple times here, but you need to run and kick to get the vertical height. That's something lots of people don't notice. You can actually get the most vertical distance, or horizontal distance, by doing a run kick. And then you need to stop time after you leave the platform to reach that. I think that was a health up. I don't know, I just always get it. You'll max out your health in all likelihood before you max out your time. Some of the last time upgrades are hidden with items you get at the very end. Or not very end, but later in the game. So we have about half of the items we get already. Also this. We want to switch that. Is this the area? Ah, crap, what do we do here? If we break all the lights? There's a thing you do here. And it causes this generator to go. Oh, I don't do this with me. How do I always forget what to do here? Wait, maybe I need that off. The game is very deliberately insane. Wait, do I stop time? Ah, I forget what I do here! Shit. Did I miss the switch? I have a feeling I missed a switch or something. I can't believe I'm doing this in a run. Wait, I think there was a switch in this last map. You either have to break all of the torches or you have to pull all the switches. Oh, I missed a switch. Ah, you gotta pull these switches. Why not save? Excuse me! Skeleton guy's a dick. And now with all of those pulled... Right. What do I do? I pull all of them but that one? Are you kidding me? I don't know what to do. Ah, shit. Hold on. I've beaten this game at least 7 times, by the way, and I forget this thing every time. Fuck, what is this area called? Wait, I think I missed another switch. Okay, do not pick continue the title. Yeah, wait. Just to make sure. Alright. I think there's a switch in here I always forget. Cause I'm always so focused on getting— yeah, it's this fucking switch. I swear, I've had to do this like 4 times now and I always forget. Because when I'm in this room, I'm focused on getting that heart, and I don't think about getting this stupid thing. I focus on getting the extras, not, you know, what you need to complete the game. Because completing the game is so blasé. What are you guys talking about over there? Don't make me come over there. Here playing a perfectly reasonable game. I swear this used to be triggered differently, because I swear you used to stand here in the darkness or something, or maybe I'm thinking of something else. But you stand on this black thing, and there's a girl having a seizure while watching a cat. Everyone takes a picture with the seizure girl. This area, dangerous. You need to reverse time so the evil bunny men will not trample you. And they're instant kill. I love that. You initially think that's a bug, and you're like, what the hell was that? But you see something at the bottom. Alright, let's go down. Alright, right, right. You do not want to run out of time in that room. Because they will kill your ass. I think I've only died to them once. It's pretty easy to... Once you know what you're doing, it's pretty easy to remember what to do there. Also, if you need to get across some place where you can't jump, you just need to do the run kick. Alright. This one? Need to... Oh god. Can I please get... Not that! Damn it, I need my self shooter. Please be a self shooter. That's... That's better than Spike Hammer. I'm just gonna ignore chat for the moment here. This? No. No, it is not this. Shit. Yeah, that was unavoidable. Aside from blocking properly like a smart person. There are destructible spikes around here somewhere. I just don't remember which ones. Everything's fine. I think it's those. I'm not brave enough to test that right now. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's the elevated ones. Alright, first things first. Let's do that. Oh god, oh god, oh god. How do I- what? Hang on. There's a thing here. Somewhere. Excuse me, sir. You're dead. There's... I thought there was a thing there. No, what? Never mind. Whatever. I didn't want it anyway. I can swear there's a frickin' bleh, heart up thinger. That was the easiest time I've ever had getting that. Sogra? For some reason, she says that when you, throw up. Also, this shows your number of deaths, or... There are two of these weird cylinder things. One of them, I think, shows your enemy kills or something, and one of them shows how many times you've died, I think. This must be the one, the number of times you died. If you go left here, you can enter an earlier area. There's lots of shortcuts you unlock in the game. We don't have use of that shortcut right now. Ow. I'm trying to be a badass, I wouldn't save as much, and you know, I would just continue on with low health, but whatever. Time doesn't matter to me right now. Not currently doing a speedrun. If I were gonna speedrun a game, in all honesty, it would be this game. I love this game. I'm probably definitely not good enough to speedrun, though. Looks like there should be something here! I like creepypasta that isn't terrible, so... Technically, no? I love horror executed well. It is not often executed well. It's a conundrum I have. Oh god, no! No! You don't... No. No. You want to leave the lights off in this area because of those heads that explode and deal lots of damage to you are very annoying. But we need the lights on later on. Oh, this area! Son of a bitch. Okay, this is the area where you need to destroy all of the lights and then wait, and then the gate opens magically. And I always get confused because there's this stupid son of a bitch. Stupid gate, or the little black thing. But yeah, this is basically a free heart container. Why are you guys talking about creepypastas and porno? There's a very good game to be talking about. We got... The Storm Orb! Yellow statues. Trebion! Also, these spikes? Complete lies! This is one of the bitchier rooms? Ow. No small part because of that. Why can't I... Block! Whatever. We're gonna waste our fucking dolls. I have 10. I don't really need 10. So what you need to do... Damn it. Why can't I... Climb up on this, trigger this, jump over there, and then climb or jump. Okay, you need to run there. The good news is you have plenty of time if you make it over. Shit. Isn't so much that this is impossible, it's just that any fuck up causes. Why can I not block? Ugh. This isn't gonna work, but let's. One more run. Bunny has a second suit that we'll see soonish, actually. Ugh. Never use the normal wall jump, it is terrible. You always want to use the wall climb. What I always do here is wait for it to trigger twice so I have. Shit. So I have shit. Also, you can land directly on that. And the wall climb really helps you get that too. It is not less clothes. You'll see. Just keep your panties on. It'll. We'll see it within like 10 minutes. Wait, I want to press a button, right? There's a light switch, which honestly, the ironic thing is this game will do a lot of stuff that's mean. One of the mean things it does is when you turn on the lights to make this area easier to navigate, these leaf heads pop up that explode and they make the area actually more annoying, but you know, easier to navigate. Yeah, that bunny doll was totally worth the 3 bunny dolls I spent getting it. Hey, Capitalist 101, by the way. Or 111, not 101. Those are the leaves I was talking about. Did they really deal that much damage, or did I take a hit earlier? But yeah, they're no good. In all honesty, there is no good reason to turn on the lights, I don't think. Like, there is to get past that one area where you need to. But there's no reason to turn on all of the lights except for a joke. It's a very lame joke, but it is my favorite. It's not really my favorite, I just really like it. I wouldn't say it looks like RPG Maker. I really like this guy's pixel art. He has really good pixel art. Get out of here, Leaf. Nobody likes your style. The girl with the green hair is called Leaf, by the way, and she explodes, and she's in almost all of Platinum Spot-Ups games in some form or another. Often as an enemy or a player character that explodes. Well, it's not 100% if I don't get that bunny doll. I'm not gonna get 100% because I don't remember exactly where everything is, but still. Oh, also, I didn't show this off. When you first come down here, there's a purple gate, and there's this orb statue on the opposite side of the gate. So you're like, oh, I must come here later or something, I don't know how to do that. And then you leave, and then you see that cutscene with the, purple-haired girl. And then she runs down here, and she breaks that gate, actually. So then the gate never spawns again. But there's no point in actually coming down here if you know what happens, so that's why I didn't. Excuse me, Leaf! Yeah, I love Bunny more than any of you. I'm sorry. Bunny is the best. I love most of the sound effects in the game except for that noise when you're going up. Do I want this? Ugh, this one's a pain. Okay. Excuse me! Eh? Eh? I didn't get hit! Okay, so the trick in this room is if you get hit, that gate closes. I don't remember getting hit, though. However, if you do get hit, you can reverse time. If you have enough time left. Alright. The dolphins want to give you kisses. You don't want that to happen. So yeah, you just need to jump off the first set of dolphins. You need to run in and hold the jump button, and you'll completely pass the first set of dolphins very easily. Do not forget to pick up this orb. Do not pick up, or forget to pick up the orbs. That loses me a lot of time very often. Alright, is your body ready for what the sign read? If you remember, it was too dark to read this sign earlier, so we're gonna read it. It says it is too dark to read what is written here. Oh. I love that. It's totally dumb, but still hilarious. Also, anyone that played the Japanese version knows there is a certain thing that does not appear in this area that used to appear in the Japanese version. I will not mention it. Only the true bunny players will ever know. Okay. Good way to get past these guys is stop time and then stomp. Oh, right. You can't kill them while stomping. But you can avoid their, you know, lasers and crap. Can I get that item? I think I can get that item. I always fall for that. Alright. There's a secret to getting out of here quick. You just break that. There's lots of one-way secrets like that just to help you get out of areas faster. There's not too many shortcuts like to advance ahead. You gotta be really inventive if you want a secret sequence break, but there are ways to sequence break like crazy. I think there's only like one or two necessary items. It's fucking insane what you can do in this game. I can't do the insane stuff though, I'm sorry. Let y'all down. And you know what? You know what? Fuck it. Get that bunny doll. You need to be very precise when you do that jump, and I just made that look easy. It's not. I'm not gonna read creepypastas while playing this game. I can barely read chat while playing this game. Also, fun extra, you can get up here thanks to the jump kicks, and you don't need to place the purple thing. But yeah, this game is pretty technical, so I need to focus, and that's why I'm not reading chat very much. Now we see these enemies, if you can even call them that, are unique to this area. And thanks to the Time Cat here, who is a massive douche, you cannot do anything about them. Because you can't stop time to avoid them or anything. Also, this guy, can I stomp on him? All right, you want to be very careful about stomping on that guy. E.g., do not stomp on that guy. Yeah, that's the shitty weapon that sucks. If you can get stuck on the stupid cats, I've had it happen once. It's like the only game-breaking bug I found, and it's not pleasant. We have the worst weapon in the game now, so that's cool. I'm very glad to hear I'm your internet brother. I think I might want to get some internet paternity tests, though. I'm not sure who my internet dad is, for one thing. Here's the annoying thing about the Rapogi missiles. They worked. They don't track very well. Like, there's only a certain number of degrees they can turn. Oh god, no. No, no! Bunny! Bunny. Okay, we're good. We're good. You can't quite jump on that one. It's possible to bounce all the way up here using the normal wall jump, but I'm actually so out of practice with the normal wall jump, I can't do it very well, because I use the wall climb all of the time. I think the Rapogi missiles do like half of the damage of the actual knives. Also, if you do a spin jump, you do a different attack, which is cool. I have no idea what you guys are talking about. Like I said, I can't read chat very accurately while I'm playing this game, because, you know, highly technical. I guess I should be this focused when playing Isaac, but I am not at all. Mostly because in Isaac I don't know what I'm doing, so I'm reading chat, you know, for all of the people telling me exactly what I'm doing wrong. Which I appreciate, you know, not to, you know, crap on people trying to help. But this game I don't need help. I do need a better weapon though. Oh my god, I hate this weapon. A lot. Spike Hammer will do. Alright! Awesome power-up time! I hope your bodies are ready. Aw, Bunny's body wasn't ready. It's ready now, though. It's ready now. Let's do this! Already an hour in? Damn. I should probably be a lot further, but I'm not. Whatever. I've been stopping to explain stuff and shit, though, so... Yeah, you need the yellow orb to come up here, so don't bother coming earlier. Once you have the ordinary, or the yellow thingy... It's time to come in here. This is another maze thing. As long as you have enough time power, this one's not too bitchy. But you do need to reverse time several times here. Or not really several, but... Oops. That's another time power. You can slow time using one of those time powers. Alright. Dynamite Body! Reduces damage, but you're a bit more top-heavy. 3A Beyond! So with Dynamite Body, your attacks are doubled in assorted ways. You take half of the damage, which makes spikes much less lethal. And you also jump, like... something that does not jump very well. I don't know what you jump like, but it's not well. Or good jumping. You, basically your jump speed, or your jump height cuts in half for the first jump. And then you're not quite in half, but it's low enough. But you jump full height the second jump. So it's still possible to get around, but it makes doing certain tricky movement stuff much harder, or occasionally impossible. You know what's funny? The one thing, the one damage it does not increase is stomping damage, even though Bunny is heavier, so she should do more stomp damage, but whatever. I probably won't keep this on for super long. It's better for boss fights than running around, because you can take more damage by not successfully doing puzzles than you can by taking damage a lot. Also, an annoying thing is, your running jump height is much lower. It's like one tile above you. But I don't need run jump height right now. I love the thump sound she makes, it's great. Ah. Let's get the light sword. Most of the weapons just spawn two weapons instead of one when you're using the dynamite body. But the light sword is different, as we will see. It's red, and it just straight up does double damage, which makes it the easiest to use. And when I'm using the dynamite body, you'll notice me doing a lot of double jump, like double hops, just because that lets you do a normal jump height, and I'm used to normal jump height. I've definitely not found any game-breaking glitches in this. I found a way to get stuck on a time cat, which makes you have to restart the game. Well, you know, reload a save. That's not very... I guess it's game-breaking in the bad way, like... It breaks your game, but not their game. Okay, it might... Alright, I do need to turn it off now. To activate that, you press down and use the time power. It's not a permanent upgrade, like it's a toggleable upgrade, because it is negative in lots of ways. I guess Sonic Rider left. Where's all my other peeps? Capitalist 101 was in here. Or 1111. I always call you 111. I don't know what I call you, just... It's not your name. I'm sorry. Also, I think those big cannons are actually invincible to anything but the spike hammer. Oops. Sit through here. And we'll get something once we get the green... orb thinger, which we'll get later. That was frisky. Oh! Do not forget to kill the time cat with the spike guhama. Oh, neat trick, if you hold attack, you can do an infinite kick. Though you're not completely invincible when you do that. I'm disappointed we get less viewers than normal. I'll probably do some other runs of this game, though, honestly. I really love this game. And I think it's decent for a stream, because, I mean... Unless I do really well, it's, like, about 2 hours, so it's a good stream-length game. And it's pretty technical, so... It's good to show off. I really wish more people would play this game, like, wish more people knew about it and stuff. Wait, where did my purple go? Oh, right, I needed it to come in here. Never mind, we're good, we're good. Now there are other bunnies, and they are very mean! Do not play with the other bunnies, they will hurt you a lot. If you must play with the other bunnies, you want to use the big boob item, because it lets you hurt them a lot more, and that's another mean thing the game does. If you ride on that elevator all the way up, you hit that spike. The game does lots of little tricks like that. Silpha Shooter! I actually want the Silpha Shooter right now. Excuse me while I whip these out. No sense in attacking this pattern. Hit this guy, you need to kill all of the little pumpkins, which is not practical when there's six. Oh, come on, man! There are patterns for 2 and 4 pumpkins as well. If he would- oh my god, I hate this guy. This fucking guy, man. See, when there's just two, it's way easier. And you want the dynamite body here just because you do way more damage. Oh, an annoying thing about dynamite body, when you land, you actually break crumblable floors because of your additional weight, which is amusing, but highly dangerous in certain fights. And I swear these boss fights are designed with that in mind, because these next few boss fights always have crumblable floors. Most boss fights do not. Oh, he has way less health than I remember. There are actually a few bullet helly bosses, if that's what you mean by Toho. The creator, Platinatus Botif, actually has lots of really good bullet hell games. Well, not lots, but he made the Gundamonium trilogy. Those games are all really good. Hidogata Happa is one of my favorite bullet hells. I did not want the Black Uwingu. We gotta bring down our cup size here for this room. I really should have killed that guy over there, but whatever. Nope. Didn't mean to bounce off of that. I don't think this is actually useful here. Oh, right. You can just sneak past this. There's some complicated... I don't even know how you get into this area without using the wall climb. But it's completely trivial without the wall climb. Though. That switch, what it does... Oops. You're so dead. Thank you. What this does... If I would not fall off... Alright. Shit. Yeah, in your first run of the game, you will fall off a lot more ledges. Let me just say that. I've done some fails here and there while playing here, but trust me, this is a pretty good run through if it doesn't look like it. This is definitely not amazing. I have definitely done better. I've definitely done a lot better, but see, the other bunnies have way more health. It's kind of unfair. They also have bazongas without, like, magic power, so that's... Oh, if you use stop time in this room, you'll get crushed! That's what all those time bricks are about in the background. Also, oops, this is not the power to have in this room. Oh, I guess it's okay. Yeah, Bullet Heaven's a really good one. I love, this guy would be dying so much faster if I weren't using the stupid Black Uwingu. Yeah, Bullet Heaven's pretty fun. It's not very hard. It's very forgiving, especially if you do, like, normal or, like, low difficulties and stuff. Right, when he bounces down, what you gotta do is jump on his head. If something doesn't frickin' stop you from jumping, son of a bitch. Alright, well, you know what? Screw it. We'll just hit him with the stupid black wing. You can bounce on his head and deal crazy damage, and it's very fun, but at the moment, that's... shit. You know what? We're getting a better frickin' weapon. Or did I get the Black Wing in here? There's usually a decent weapon for the next boss. I'm not sure that counts. Whatever. Oh, yes, that is. This is definitely a good weapon here. Never mind, I'm stupid. This is the ideal weapon for this boss. There's usually the ideal weapon for the boss in the area right before it. Or, you know, at least a good one. There are also achievements for beating bosses using either ideal or not ideal weapons. It's kind of a mixed bag. Like, some bosses are easily decimated using certain weapons and they'll give you an achievement for that. And sometimes bosses are really hard with it. There we go. Are you fucking kidding me? Whatever, we have plenty of extra lives. Gradius is... especially Gradius 3 or whatever the SNES one is, it's a really good game. I think it's actually spoiled a lot because of its difficulty. Because the thing is, once you lose all of your power-ups, it just becomes completely unfair. And during the boss rush, it's just complete bullshit if you lose your power-ups. And I mean, it's still a fun game, and I recommend going through it even if it's with cheats. But... I don't know, even as the super manly man game, I think the difficulty is a bit too much. At least for a, you know, game without difficulty modes. If you didn't know, Gradius was one of the games... Alright, the other bunnies are not affected by your... shit. By your time bullshit, so, you don't want to fuck around with them. Also, your weapons do not do damage when your time is stopped, so you gotta stomp them. Are you invincible when time is stopped? Yeah, you're invincible when time is stopped. Well, life lesson learned. Alright, this is the way to get down easy. We don't want to do that yet. Ah. You can kill these. They take a lot of damage, though. You know what? What am I doing? Are you kidding? Die. Now. If you do this just right... First try. If you do that just right, if you're facing the right direction, you can climb up there. That's trickier than it looks, because if you're facing right, you can't wall climb. You gotta face the wall that you're gonna bounce off of. Now the time has stopped. I also love the blue, like, shadow effect the bunny has. I think we want dynamite body for this one. Oh shit. I wanted knives for this. Whatever, we'll use what we got. The bullet, or the reason for the bullet hell references here is because the pumpkin guys are most often enemies in the bullet hell games of his. I guess they're all of his. This guy basically has three... No, he has one... He actually has something really mean he does at the very end. What you'll need to do here is bounce on him. Otherwise, it's basically impossible. And you gotta bounce him off of him just right. But that went exceedingly well. Also, elevators that lead you into spikes! Good times! But whatever, there's a save point here. Also, I really like this one. Super Gradius was on Super Nintendo, though. It wasn't... I mean, if it was after your quarters, it was kind of... you know, dumb. What you gotta do here is bounce off of these things. Can I... And we need to... Do I have pyre jump height? No. No, I don't. Okay, I want dynamite body for this last area, then. Also, I like that one, because you have to switch over the lasers, which is fun. I really like that room with the bouncing on the lasers. What's in you? Oh. Are you kidding? And there wasn't anything in there. Ah! I thought there would be a weapon in there. Whatever. It's Pumpkinhead Girl! Also, I love that... Bunny's, like, always really pissed that she can't, like, none of the bosses talk to her. Right, this boss is annoying. You know what? Dynamite Body is, like, very good for this fight, because you don't need too much mobility, and you can take a lot of damage if you're not careful. You can dodge the flames if you're good. I don't really have the timing down anymore. It's important to note you can block pretty much anything if you have the timing down for the block or the parry. Then you just, you know, press a direction when you're gonna get hit. But I don't really have that down anymore, so you're gonna not see as much of that as you could if I had practiced, which, you know. Also, most damaging attack is actually the kick, if you can get it right. At least the most DPS. But it can be very hard to get a good kick in. Excuse me, would you just die? You have, like, no health. There you go. This room is reasonably, like, I remember having a little issues getting up here without the wall climb. The game is a lot easier once you know you can wall climb. Alright, let's go. We have defeated all of the devils, and we can now fight the final boss. Ish. Final-ish. There's actually a whole second character you can play as. Yeah, I love the Yata. Let's take a pick. You know the victory pose and the little Yata she does when you beat a boss? Go. Yata! Hey. Excuse me, I just want to get down! Oh. Right. The game is mean! Sometimes. Often! Fuck. I wanted that time. I shouldn't have saved, I should have just reloaded. Whatever. Yeah, the game's only 2 hours if you're, like, decent. 1 hour if you're crazy good. But as a telling statistic, it actually took me 6 hours to 100% complete the first time. You're seeing not really a speed run, but, you know, a pretty good playthrough here. Alright. Ah, god damn it. That spike is perfectly placed. So that if you run and bump into it... Don't worry, the final boss will take a while. She has, like, bullet hell number of phases. A staple in bullet hell fighters, or not fighters, shooters, is that... How would a bullet hell fighter work? But yeah, a common thing is you will, You know what, fuck it. Did I save? That just pisses me off. I used to be able to do that. Oh, I saved down here. Son of a bitch! I want that stupid time power up. Also, just because we can unlock the final boss doesn't mean it's a good idea to fight the final boss yet. There's still... Oh, I have max health. There's still, like, 3 or 4 upgrades to get. Time upgrades. I think that must be 4. Yo, What you want to do is, even if you take damage... Alright, recovery! Recovery is another funny one. Let's heal! For some reason, her boob's going in and out when you heal. That's useful, but not super... Oh, right, that was a thing. I needed to show that off anyway. Silpha Shooter! Yoink! Oh, is there any... Damn it. Is there anything... Oh, right. You can fall through that, and it spikes. Anything here? Basically, we want to go back to the starting area to continue on. Basically, every place where we saw a green totem pole thingy, which we didn't actually see very many of. Excuse me. Alright. No! There. This is pretty tricky timing. Or you can just wall climb. Alright, the final time power is basically the good ending. You'll see why it's a time power later on. 3 days remaining. Yes. No, I don't want that. Well, fuck me! I guess I do want that then, sure, whatever. Like I give a fuck. How many people already know what the secret is? Probably not many. This game is unfortunately very obscure. I wish this game were a lot more well known. That's why I was gonna try to... My original plans for the 1000 subscriber special or something was this game, but then I realized... Like, ideally, I want lots of people to see the game, and I still wasn't getting that many views on a normal video. But, yeah. Also, a mean trick, you can get through here if you press, if you put the red, thinger, the red key here. But you need to go through up here. Because, there will actually be another red key. Just not another, fuck. Yeah, that's how you get squished. This is one of few rooms where that's actually a concern. You want to be very careful around these guys because of that. Bunny is a fourth wall breaker. There'll be some fourth wall breaking, I forget exactly when. Spike a hammer! Love the music here. This is a really cool area. Oh, wait. No, that's not here. Nah, I don't need that extra time. I'm basically skipping one time up by going through now. Also, you can bounce off of fire indefinitely if you have the timing down right for the parry. I also think we might need that block. Metroid doors! Elevator levels! This game is pretty hard. People overestimate the difficulty, though. It's really... The controls make it work really well. But you gotta... It's not quite like anything else, so you gotta get used to it a bit. It's totally worth it, though. It is, and probably always will be, one of, if not my favorite, Metroidvania, actually. Like, Symphony of the Night's way up there, but it's kind of a different game in a lot of ways, because it's got the level aspect. I'm not sure what the purple spikes are about there. Oh right, they do bad things if you stay up there. Ah, shit. You can really just stand in the middle and parry if you have your timing down right. Like I magically happened to do there. There's a way to get in that door. This game really isn't much like Cave Story at all. Not so much... What? Oh, fuck. I forgot to view the cutscene thing. It didn't so much fall short as it just hasn't got the thing. I think it's still on Greenlight. But what pisses me off about seeing Greenlight here is it's published by Rockin' Android in the States, and Rockin' Android has published on Steam before several times, yet this game, they're like, no, you gotta go through Steam Greenlight because you're a fucking indie piece of shit. Fucking goddamn casuals. Ugh. I don't like Valve anymore. I'm gonna say that right now. I used to love Valve. They were my favorite freaking game company. Now they're pretty much just Dota 2 and Team Fortress 2 and Steam. I love Steam, but... They've been going for this free-to-play shit. They've been going for, you know, everything about Greenlight pretty much is a train wreck. They're not the same company at this point that made Half-Life and Half-Life 2 and Portal. I just don't see it anymore. Shit. This room is mean. I wouldn't say dead, but they seem much more interested in a lot of the gaming scene that I do not like. The free-to-play stuff, now the MOBA stuff. They seem a lot like EA, except with a better PR department at this point. Because guess who's only doing online experiences and free-to-play? Is that EA or is that Valve? The main difference is that Valve knows when to keep their fucking mouth shut, and EA doesn't. And EA actually makes games? I am not angry, I am simply espousing my opinions on a company that I am now quite annoyed with. You need the little green thing to get to there, the green orby. But I don't have it, but that's where the last time power-up is. We don't really need it. It's a little useful in the final battle, but eh. Oh hey, it's Tyler. What's going on? Calm up. Calm up, stupid. I make that joke all the time and no one ever gets it. A few people get it, but you know what I mean. I didn't go do the thing I was supposed to do. Alright. Alright. We came here for naught, so we're gonna try to get an item we are missing. Forget if it's a time power or... Ugh. You missed my non-tutorial on the first boss, where I just completely stomped her. Where's the... Huh? There's a way to get into that door, and I don't remember what it is. Must be a switch. I do not recall. Speaking of the music, now that we've heard everything, next save point I get to, I'm gonna change back to the original music. I'm not sure which I would say I like better, but I really like both of them. Actually, I'm not sure if I can change the music in the mid-game. The original music is very different. Go, go, go! It is this different. You are now listening to the rearranged, or not the rearranged, the deranged, the normal. I'm not sure how I would quantify how different it is. It's just, like, completely different. It's not like Cave Story, where the rearranged music is complete fucking garbage, but, ugh. I gave Cave Story's rearranged soundtrack a chance, and then Grasstown happened, and I turned that shit right off. You don't fuck with Grasstown. You do not fuck with Grasstown. Oh, right. I was supposed to go... no, I did not. I didn't get Cave Story 3D. I just have Cave Story and Cave Story Plus. You're supposed to go into this and use your time, and then you see her. I always forget to get this one, too. Just because I've played through the game like 7 or 8 times doesn't mean I remember what the hell I'm doing. I have the muscle memory for the most part, but there's these little stupid things I just forget. Yeah, no shit. I was replaying Cave Story Plus with the rearranged music, and I entered Grasstown. I'm like, wait a minute, this doesn't even sound like Grasstown. And then I listened for a minute, you know, seeing if it would get better, and then I stopped playing. I could have, like, went back to the normal music, but I don't know. I just lost the spark. At some point, I plan to do a full playthrough of Cave Story Plus, but I mean... And not all of the rearranged stuff was bad. It's just that the Grasstown was like, what did you even do? There's a thing you do here. Is it that? No. I need a non-suck weapon, please. There we go. Wait. Oh, right. The game likes secrets. Now, is the Cave Story 3D music different again? That was bad. Okay. As long as you keep bouncing off of these, they won't fall down, which is important. Fuck. There we go. If you're very calm, you can block the spikes very easily. Or very consistently. You still have to get it down. Also, if you switch time while you're already on a time block, you will get squished, I think. So you gotta be careful with that. Right. Oh! Oh right, there's one more time power to get. We're gonna heal up. That's not healing. That is hopefully enough. This is also not the form we want to be in for this. Well, I guess it doesn't matter as much. The exit isn't as technical as the. Ah, oh, shit. This is bad. Okay. Oh, right! If you get enough time, there's an unlabeled, thing where you'll actually... How do I get back in? There's basically X-ray visor if you get almost all of the time stuff. Huh? Ah, I see. It does not uncover completely everything. We go. Alright. Do I need anything else? No. You can actually head back in. This is still a shortcut. Nothing really stops being a shortcut. Bunny, come on. And if you get used to it... Yeah, this music was more dramatic. Oh, right. Some of the bunny doll locations become completely apparent. Excuse me. Okay, I don't think you can kill those. Alright. We gotta... reduce the boobage there. Yeah, why did they change it to Bushlands, too? I mean... Wait. Oh, right, also, the X-ray visor thing is only in effect when you are in, Dynamite Body Mode, or whatever it's called. I think that's what it's called. So that's additional reason to use this, which is good because while the damage boost and defense boost are nice, I don't usually use this because it makes jumping that much more cumbersome. Alright, now we can go all the way down. Yeah, we're gonna save first. Like, if you get used to jumping- oh. We can't save! Well? Well, fuck it, let's do it. There are certain phases of the final boss that you want to be a certain form, and some where you'd want to be the other form. This is Chelsea, the main character of the game? No, she's not. She's terrible and she sucks, and we hate her. You can play through the game again as Chelsea. I've only beaten the Chelsea game once, because Chelsea is the floaty type. You know, she's... she's that floaty type of character that functions very different from Bunny, and I really don't like her playstyle at all. She just not nearly as fun. Sprigahama! Stop, 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 stop. You want to be careful here because you don't want to be on the hammer as it goes up, because she will squish you outside of the map. Oh god, this! This is mean! No! Okay, you can block it, but that isn't- that, sniper shot is an instant kill. No! And do not try to block it unless you are insanely good, because it is not worth it. Shit. She's floaty in that she has a button that makes her float. She's a lot more like Quote, but like even more floaty. She has a... not sure if it's an ability or just an innate thing for her, but... she like literally floats. Ugh, and she does it, she gets two. I think I should have been hit there, but apparently I was like, well, run! Bunny, don't you frickin' die, you frickin' bitch! I don't like Chelsea, if you didn't get that yet. She makes me very angry. I don't remember the trick to this one. I really don't remember the trick to this one. I think maybe just erase your energy balls? Yeah, I think you destroy your energy balls. Either that or you ride them up and attack her, which I'm not sure that's gonna happen. Holy crap, they deal lots of damage. Also, you can take half of her damage out with a nice kick, which is very good. I really forget the trick to this one. She does not have much health, though, in this form. Oh god, you do abs- No! Fucking switch, bunny! For this one, you gotta stomp all the swords in. You gotta stomp them in 3 times. And you absolutely do not want to be big-chested bunny for this one. Also, those things hurt a lot. And you get lots of magic, or time, really, when you do these fights, so you want to make use of your heals when you can, when she gives you little windows like she is about to not give me. Ah. Excuse me. I'm sure you mean my generic Dragon Z blasts. I mean, just an energy blast is hardly Dragon Ball Z at this point. It's just, it's generic, but I mean, it's not really Dragon Ball Z. Unless, you know, they actually do like Spirit Bomb animation or something. There's only so many ways you can make a fireball that is a fireball and balls fire at you. Ow. Whatevs. Dead! Bullet hell time! No, the other times were not bullet hell time. This is bullet hell time. Come on, do the spin pattern, come on. You say Cave Story made everything better. Cave Story is a good game, but comparing this game to Cave Story, I would not consider that particularly valid comparison. Like, in the sense that it is a game that is vaguely platformery and you collect items, yes. It is a Metroidvania, but the combat and everything, completely different. This is more traditional platformery combat. Cave Story is more of shooter platformer. It's like the difference between Gunstar Heroes and Super Mario. This is the one I wanted to see. That one is a bit safer to mess with than this one. No, and you're not even gonna do it twice. It's a bit safer in the corners with this one. The sword is sort of risky in this one. In this fight in general, but it's actually very good for erasing her bullets. Any of the candy corn bullets can be erased. Aw, come on. Aw, damn it, I missed my write-up. And now I'm not gonna get a write-up. They loved Gunstar Heroes. Treasure was great. Shit. She does crazy damage with that laser in this final form. Excuse me, was I even in this form? The most forgiving thing the entire game does is that if you use a bunny doll on the final boss, she uses, you get, you know, you're at that same form that you were last time, if I could talk. Also, if you have absolutely perfect timing, you can actually block all of that laser, like, just straight up block it. I'm not that good. Ha! Owned. If you can kick her, you do tons of damage. Oh, they made Sin and Punishment. I actually may have to... Sin and Punishment was, like, N64, though. I may have to check that out. I didn't realize they made that. I saw that on the WiiWare thing, but I was kind of annoyed that they didn't bother translating the game, but they're still going to charge you more for it over the Virtual Console. Did they make an actual Virtual Console, or an actual Wii version, or is that just the, whatchamacallit? It was an actual Wii version or just the Virtual Console? Oh hey, it's the good guy! The bunny guy cursed us. What? Yeah. He's a jerkbag. We killed the seven devils to help him, because he's an asshole. You just crossed the line, Buster. You're just now catching up with the plot, are we? He tries to steal our power, but... Yeah, turns out Chelsea wasn't bad after all. She's gonna try and help us. The real final boss actually involves both characters, but I don't have time to do Chelsea's full playthrough. So yeah, he's a jerk. And then we have time power! Activate! That's your final power. It, brings you... Well, it gives you the good ending, basically, and it lets you play as Chelsea. I'm not sure if you get Chelsea... I don't think you get Chelsea if you don't have that power active. And you don't actually see the full credits if you get the bad ending. I think it's just like, yeah, you screwed up. Go get more time powers. Wow, that is terrible time. Item rate 86%. Not terrible considering I know I missed a bunch. And the title screen changes! It actually changes once again once you beat Chelsea and the Seven Devils. I'll give you a very quick peek at Chelsea. We will name her Butt, because that's what she is. I got that time because every time you save, it adds 1 second, or adds... No, it adds a minute. So yeah, rabbits take their duties very seriously, allowing people to, time to flow. This is what rabbits actually do. But then a bad rabbit got some uppity ideas. People and their uppity ideas. And by people, I mean rabbits. Devil to Cronus. Yeah, that's the stupid fat prophet. We don't like that guy. Chelsea is a butt queen. I think she actually is a queen. Like, she's a fairy queen or some crap, I think. I don't remember this part of the story that well. Because Chelsea kinda sucks. Oh wait, no, we're a prince, basically, I guess. Did they say prince or princess? Whatever, she's both. Yeah, she shoots. Which actually makes it very much more like Cave Story, now that I think about it. But yeah, she shoots. And she has that rush thing. She actually has some alright attacks. I just don't like her compared to Bunny. You got the ice power! Yeah, she actually floats, and she has a higher jump. And she cannot activate switches, because she's dumb. I don't know. I guess because she's lighter than Bunny? She shoots candy corns, and you get more candy corns as you beat the seven devils, which is actually pretty cool. That's one of my favorite things about her. Yeah, as you see there, since I saved there, my time went way up. And Chelsea gets mana rather than time power. I forget what we even do. We got the mana power! Mana is used in discrete units instead of a health bar type thing. Like, you get, you know, X charges of it. Nah, I think I need an item to get that. But yeah, she can go over long gaps. She also does not have collectible weapons, unlike Bunny. Also, she can shoot down! Alright, I completely forget how to fight all of the bosses as her. Yeah, we're gonna kill her because she doesn't like blue cheese. Or because she prefers blue cheese. Oh wow, I have no idea what I am doing. I don't even know if I can do anything with my mana. Chelsea's bad, she should feel bad. She's not quite this bad, I just have no idea what I'm doing. Not really, she seems to have, there seems to have been, like, thought gone, like, that went into how her stuff works. Oh, she can stomp. Well, score one for her. Bunny is definitely way more satisfying to play as. She's a lot more technical and a lot more fun. Whereas Chelsea is just like shooting candy corns and I don't even know. She misses purple hair over here and parachute pants. She's freaking the 80s over here. That's what she is. She is the 80s. The entire 80s. Excuse me! I hate you! She is a lot more viable once you get her better weapons, though. Because she will shoot way more... She'll shoot much wider bullets. Or wider bullet patterns, rather. Oh. Damn it. Damn it! Why can't I do that right? This basically is playing a lot more like my first try with Bunny. And it's been a long time since I was bad at this game. Well, since I was this bad at this game, anyway. Aha! I win! Aw, are you fucking kidding me? I could have killed her there. I honestly don't know what 80s, like, too much about 80s crap. I mean, I was born in the 90s and everything before that seems pretty stupid and ridiculous. Which is saying something, because the 90s had lots of stupid, ridiculous stuff. But I mean, 80s hair, my god. People in the past were dumb. I mean, you gotta be dumb to live in the past. I mean, why wouldn't you want to live in the present? I mean, come on, guys. I swear she moves more horizontally when you stomp. I'm just gonna avoid her shots and wait for the stomp, because that's the most viable way to do this, it seems. Or rather, it's the way I know how to do the best. To do that a few times, and then, yep. Oh, hey Tyler, did you want me to show you how to do the, how to fight the normal, the first boss here, with Bunny?
You got new experiment?
I completely forgot you said that. But yeah, she does... Her items are completely different. See, one of them is a frickin' ladder. Which is useful for getting out of, like, places where she can't... She can't do the crazy jumps, so... She needs the ladder on occasion. Bullet hell. You didn't beat the first the second boss before the first boss, did you? Because that is a bad thing to have done. You shouldn't have done that. But no, that's pretty much the same, like, you fight differently, but she doesn't. The boss herself. Oh well, we'll get to the next save point and I'll show you, how to do it with Bunny. How do I... Oh. Also, it's an attack! Which is actually kind of cool. Wow. I completely forget her route. Apparently that's not it. Oh. Well, we're here. Whatever. I don't like Chelsea. Let's erase this one. I wish the game had more save files. I'm original with names. Very original. Where's H? Yeah, she has more cool stuff than I give her credit for. Her items are actually pretty cool, and it's decently fun to play through. The difference is Chelsea is fun to play through once. I think Bunny is more fun to play through repeatedly, because Bunny, there's a lot more stuff to master. And, you know, it just has that more technical feel. Alright, so... To beat the first boss, first thing you want to do, after getting the ability to walk to the right, you want to get this health up. If you didn't get that, it's going to be a lot harder, because that doubles your life. And you also want to get the time up. There's a time up that's pretty hard to miss. It is over here. Excuse me. I don't actually use this in that boss at all, but you may as well get it. Now what we want to do is get this. That is harder to find because you want to break all of the lamps. Certain lamps will always have certain weapons in them, and all the others will have time in them. The sword makes this fight easier, especially if you're just going to like bash your way through it. But basically what you want to do... Also, the sword erases those fireballs. And what you want to do is stomp on her head, and you just want to jump and then not hold the jump button while you're bouncing on her head, and just sort of move back and forth to keep stable on her head, and you can deal a good chunk of her health that way. Stomp is actually quite useful, even though it's not immediately obvious that you'd want to do that. She definitely has the better fight, or winning pose. Also, now that I've done that, I guess I may as well show you the, sequence break. The interesting thing here, at first, sequence breaking doesn't seem like a bad thing, because the fight is not really that hard. Well, it's pretty short. You might die a few times, but once you get the hang of it, not too bad. Oh, that is not how you do it. Yeah, there's lots of stuff you gotta learn about the game to play it really well. But that's what I like about it. You learn a lot about it, and you feel a lot better about your second playthrough. And the game doesn't really coddle you too much, it just... Ah. Alright. So what we want to do is ride on these lasers. You gotta... Ah. This might take a few tries. Yeah, what we want is for him to fire a laser straight across. Not like that. And it's kind of annoying, because if he's not in the right position, it's not going to work. But it's not supposed to be easy. Also, do not do this your first playthrough. I'm just doing this for demonstration. Because even the first, just because it's not hard to fight this boss, the first boss actually gets pissed off that you fought the other boss first, and she becomes way, way harder. Like, one of the final bosses phases hard. There we go. That's the exact angle you want. Alright, now until you get so much time power, stopping time actually slowly depletes your time. Not entirely sure why, since after like 2 or 3 time power-ups, you get the good time skill. Oh, this boss is harder when you don't beat the first boss because you can't do the dash kick. The dash kick is instrumental to beating this guy quickly, but you can also just spam the sword and dodge the hits. The sword is very useful because it... Aw, damn it. I was getting a good loop there. So, you know, it erases bullets. Oh god, do not... His contact damage is insane. Always prefer getting hit by the bullets to contact damage. See, not too bad, right? Not too bad. Oh, the backslide, you mean? Yeah, that could work. I never use the backslide. I never think to use it. If you fought this boss first, then yeah, you're gonna get craziness. And you'll just want to restart your save file. Because, I mean, it takes literally 2 minutes to get to that boss, or less. So yeah, you just want to fight her first. You can go around and pick up life-ups. Like, you can continue on and get extra power-ups before you fight her. I think you can get decently far. I'll just get one. I don't know. Backdashing isn't actually that useful against that boss because, that second boss, because those lasers will block your passage. Oh, wait, I'm not sure I can't... Oh, yeah, I need more time, that's what I need. It doesn't matter, I don't really need to beat her. I have beaten her once in Piss Off Boss Mode. I only got, like, a couple of heart containers. That's probably not gonna happen this time. Yeah, if you really want to beat this boss, what you want to do is continue on as far as you can without the dash power. And you want to get more health ups, because you can get at least 2, I think? Maybe more, before you fight her, and like more time too. But look, she's the first devil. First? What do you mean? I'm the first, so I'm the first. No, you're not the first, not at all. Don't tell me. You better not have defeated the other devils before me. As if that really matters. It matters to me! I thought you were taking too long! You're kidding, this is unforgivable. I'm gonna put your name in my book of revenge. Die! Big ol' forehead! Okay, that's a decent line. This girl's like a broken record. Is this what you fought? Cause yeah, this is much harder. Let's give that another try, but yeah, I'm not sure I'm gonna be able to beat her. I did beat her once, I think, with this much health, actually. If you can learn to parry, it's very useful. I haven't put much priority on it. Wow. Yeah, I don't think I'd be able to beat her. If you got that version, you just want to restart your save, because... This is a good challenge once you've beaten the game once. Oh, right, and she actually aims up with that. So you actually want to keep hitting her with the sword. The sword is still the best option for her. Oh. We'll test one more thing and then we're gonna end the stream. This has been my standard 2 hours. And then on Thursday, we're going to be playing more Binding of Isaac. Ow. Yeah, she hurts way too much. It's definitely possible, but there's a reason there's an achievement. Oh, right. The records are basically your achievements. You don't get too many of them in a normal playthrough, but there's lots of extra stuff you can do. Yeah, there's one for doing the sequence break. I think there is one for beating the game without getting the item that lets you walk to the right, which is completely possible, by the way. And I think there may be some for some other skips. The game's very aware of its skips, and they're very hard to do. It's not like super easy stuff that was overlooked, like in Metroid. Like, not all the skips are super easy, but... the skips were definitely designed intentionally. Like, maybe not all of them, but... pretty good design in there. Alright. Well, that wraps it up. We may play Bunny Must Die a bit better on a later stream, but... for now, we're going to call that a wrap and play Binding of Isaac Thursday, 7 p.m. Central. We're going to stick to the Tuesday and Thursday stream schedules, so keep that in mind. Don't wait for the videos to go up on YouTube, because that's... people are always late when they try to go buy the YouTube videos. All right, thanks for watching, everybody. Hope you enjoyed Bunny Must Die. I strongly recommend getting it. Like, let me... in case anyone wants it. They actually got a website, they're all legit now. It took for frickin' ever for them to actually come out in the US. Or, not US, but just English. But yeah, there's the link to, you just go to bunnymustdie.com. You can vote for it on Greenlight. Even if you're not gonna buy it, I strongly recommend, like, I ask that you vote for it on Greenlight, because I really, really want to see this game on Steam. But you can also buy it on Dashura and Gamersgate and Playism right now. I think it is $10? I bought the Dashura one. That's the one with the new, you know, translation batch and everything. It'll be the same as the Steam version. But yeah, it's $10 on there. There's also a demo you can play. Yeah, I'll see you guys. Thanks for watching.